Hi, Poopsies. Welcome to the most relaxing ASMR video ever made, part 7. And of course, it's ever made because it really isn't. That's just the name of the title and nothing more. I'm not crediting myself for being the most relaxing. If I did, I would be God. So, anyway, welcome. And I'm happy you're here. This is going to be a really simple video. And that's basically it. This is probably one of my most simplest ones because I really wanted to focus on the ASMR aspect, where there is a lot more sort of, not really personal attention, but kind of like just simple triggers. People request simplicity, nothing too difficult, nothing out of focus, out of the ordinary. This is just something basically everybody else would do. So I wanted to add that and provide that for you and bring back some of the things that you've been requesting and just sort of keep it fresh, keep it new. But you'll see overall, I'm just trying to present to you this super long video. So I hope you enjoy this and have fun. Okay, these are the original Spirographs, and these are one of the toys I showed in my toy shop roleplay video. And you can see the combination of many different wheels here. These are used for drawing these Spirographs, which are these colorful designs here. This little pamphlet, you can see instructions for drawing multiple, various different kinds of Spirographs. You can even use different colored pens to draw these with. Pretty creative. You can go crazy with this. So right now I'm going to take out these papers and work on this plastic container because this doesn't bleed through with the pen and it's safe and I don't want to damage my table. Safely without damaging. And I have three different colored pens here. One is red, one is blue, and one is green. So I'm going to start off with the basic wheel here. I'm going to lay it flat here. And then get a tinier wheel to work with on the inside. And I'm going to zoom in a bit more. And I'm going to grab some of this putty. It's a little bit like gum. So I put it on the underside of the wheel, just like this. So it would stay on the paper when I squeeze it. I'm going to put a little bit more on the other side, right about here, right here. tinier wheel. Here, where they can lock in the gears here. So I'm going to open up this red pen now. And of course I want to test first if the ink works. And then I will just begin. Start right here. And work. Feels a bit strange doing this. This is my first time working with the Spirograph. But something tells me I'm already gonna be pretty good at it. So there's my first pattern. It's so beautiful. I'm actually very impressed. Didn't expect it to come out this good. I think this would add for some relaxing thing to do. And my bird is so cute, you can probably hear him in the background. He is crunching his beak from time to time. So I'm gonna do my next pattern. I'm gonna try to go very slow here. So it's kind of going to be like a flower, lotus flower kind of thing. And it ends off there. So double patterned leaf. And then finally, I move this to my last location, which is here. And I spin. Keep pushing and making sure it locks in the wheels, otherwise it's a bit difficult. See, I messed up. If you go a little bit too fast, you kind of mess up. So once that's taken care of, you twist the wheel and slowly remove the putty. If you pull it, you can risk ripping the paper. So you can see a beautiful leaf flower. Now I'm going to go on the more extreme and do a bigger pattern. Let's see here, I'm going to go with this little one here and see what that does. So I'm going to start putting the putty first. I like that word, putty. So I put that there, lock it in place. And then I begin my adventures. Okay. All right. And do it one last time. place if you're missing something like that. Well, that's basically it. It's real pretty. Both flowers. And there's, of course, the more extreme cases where you can do some crazy color patterns. Let's say I put this here, and I use this here to make patterns. So let's say I begin from here and then I go all crazy. I'm not even sure if this works completely. It's kind of difficult to keep this to stay on the actual device, but you basically get the gist of it, and you can even switch up pieces and do something a little more easier, such as this perhaps. To keep it in place, but you basically get the point of it. This part I am not really good at. I can maybe get an enormous sized circle, and you can go in any number you wish, let's say 26 here. You go crazy. Basically gonna go in like a spiral formation. It's way easier to do this on this stick if you use the circles rather than using the oddly shaped pieces. So once you take this off, you have this very odd formation that doesn't even make sense. There we go, now it makes sense. So thank you for watching this portion, and I'm gonna move on to the next trigger now. I'm gonna start off now with this trigger, and I'm going to speak softly in both of your ears. And this has not been done enough. This video I have been studying for about a month. It is a Reiki roleplay, and I'm not saying specifically what kind of Reiki yet, or what I'm going to be doing in it, but I thought I would bring that up. Share with you something Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook the most, so that's where you guys should keep following me and checking back on new posts and things, because you get for free updated material from me. I'm not making a Patreon account. I'm not asking you for money to post updates. That's not me. And I can get my money from elsewhere. So I would much rather be honest with you and give that to you for free. I would really appreciate if you guys keep following me on there, because that is the best place to get constant posts. And once in a while, I even do ASMR on there. So I'm very active on there now. I'm trying to be more in the coming year, 2017. And I'm just putting more and more effort every year. So I can't wait to see what kind of content I post for you this year. Definitely going to be uploading around 100 plus videos this year. I can't wait. And definitely can't wait to hear what you think. I find it seems to be working really well if I upload even more than twice a week, but the reason I did it for December was because of the holidays. So I posted in December alone, and I wanted to treat you guys and surprise you and give you well-deserved uploads after a long year. So that's how it is. But I was really satisfied with the last part of the series, part 6. I did a lot of things I like to do, and I thought it was unique, and nobody ever thought of those ideas before. So I like each and every one of my videos to be unique in their own way, something people don't usually do, and I like having my different backgrounds in every video. I don't like filming in the exact same location multiple times. There always has to be some variation and little differences here and there in my videos. So I like to keep it that way and keep myself different from others, because that's just me. And next year I'm also hoping to get in a lot more massage videos. I've only done one because, as you know, I am licensed in massage therapy, and I'm now also certified in Reiki Master, level 1, 2, and Master Reiki healing. So I'm definitely going to be doing that next year. I am going to try to, by next year I mean 2017, I am going to try to get that in as much as I can. There's still no promises because I said I was going to this year, and it turns out I was busier than I thought, and I was not able to do so much with that. But I did do a lot of videos that I have been stalling to do to do in forever, so that is a plus for sure. So I'm really grateful that I was able to do that and do so much more this year in regards to all of that. And so cheers to that. Cheers to 2017. Wherever where this is going. I don't know at all. Neither does anybody else. But I'm really enjoying the long journey that I've been through with everything, for sure. It's been a really great year for me. And I just want to keep going. That's all I want to do, is just keep uploading videos. This is my passion, and I just want to provide for you. And but with a slight change, I want to remember to take care of myself more this coming year, because a lot of that has to be abandoned last year, because I was so focused and so not used to the routine. But once I built a steady ground routine, and I'm slowly growing the confidence in it every day, then I'm able to do it. And I plan to release maybe 2 or 3 editions for Ugga Chunga this year as well, so I'm really looking forward to that and giving you so much more. And speaking of Ugga Chunga, in part 8, I will release Ugga Chunga edition number 2, numero dos, and we are selling wrist bracelet, earring, and a bath bomb. They are pretty much almost done being put together and formulated, the ideas for it, but they're coming maybe sometime around March. Something tells me March. They were supposed to be out around April, but it became sooner than we expected, so that's good news. And so you only have about a couple months away, I guess, from the time this was uploaded. And they're still valuable. Some of them will still be quite costly because of the amount of work it takes to make them and the materials, but there are a few in there that are quite affordable, even if it's going to be a little bit more than what you normally pay for a bath bomb, or a little bit more than what you normally pay for a candle, for example. But these are not just any ordinary candles or bath bombs, and you will see why coming soon. Is the brand and message behind Ugga Chunga. And we want to spread that message and basically just make it our own, make it custom, make it whatever that we have a vision for. So, of course, we want to stay with the big and chunky things, so these bath bombs to be bigger than normal. The candles are going to be bigger than normal. Just bigger than better, basically. Same with the jewelry. And so we have worldwide free shipping on all of our Ugga Chunga items in our store. So with that said, you don't have to pay a dime for shipping. It's already added in the cost of the item, calculated for ahead of time, so you never have to have any extra hidden charges for shipping. It's just the price listed on our website, ugachunga.com. So I haven't spoken about Ugga Chunga in a very long time, so I thought I would bring that up now. And again, as it is my own business, and it feels great promoting my own things instead of somebody else's. So, that is in the hopes of my poopsies admiring each and every piece we create, me and Jenny. And cheers to that. Cheers to more. So, what else did I want to talk about while I'm still here? There were a lot of closed projects for videos, but there are a lot more that I'm gonna do, where there are like part one, part two kind of things. So I wanted to just bring that up and make you more aware of that, that this is a constantly evolving place where I can spread and see if you like them, as I love to experiment. So, I do hope you enjoyed this ear-to-ear chit-chat with whisper, soft-spoken goodness. And I hope you like the simplicity. And up next is another trigger. Next up, this Grow and Glow Terrarium, and this is basically a garden jar. I've shown this again in my toy shop roleplay, and it glows in the dark with the stickers. It's pretty fancy, and it's for ages 6 to 96, so I think the little child in me can come out today. First, so I have to strategically plan around that. These are the glow-in-the-dark stickers. This is the potting soil. I'm supposed to, it shows here, I'm supposed to put half of the soil in, so I'm going to do that now. See better. That's about enough. the soil. It's about that much in. About a centimeter or two of soil on the bottom. And then I put all of the sand on top of that. Take out some of the sand and mist the soil a bit to keep it in place, because I just read in the instruction manual now that you have to mist each layer as you go along. So I'm gonna do that from now on. And now I'm gonna mist this sand layer on top a few times. Just keep everything in place. And now I put the rocks. That settles it. And now I mist again. Okay, should be moist enough. And then I put the potting soil one last time. Time. Okay, and as you can see, the layers are set in place. It is now an official terrarium. However, this package did not come with the seeds, so I'm going to get a refund on this purchase. I was very disappointed. I'm going to put the mushroom and the rabbit inside. Many to choose from here, as you can see. But even if I didn't get to put the seeds in, still makes for a quite relaxing session. Figured since I couldn't show it in the toy shop, I would show it here. I'm going to start by labeling the side with the flower, right about here. You can put the flower, and then I could put this bumblebee somewhere here. Butterfly I can paste here. pretty already. I love it. Okay, put the sun here. Gotta get some sunlight going. I'm gonna put this plant here on the side. Just keep doing that until I use all the stickers and fill up the terrarium. It doesn't have to be in the sky. I could also put some stickers in the soil. But it's up to you in the end what you do with your terrarium. So after that, you would put the lid on. So this is basically it. That's your terrarium, minus the seeds. If you want to try this out for yourself, I would love to see what kind of terrarium you make. You can even make this from home. You don't necessarily have to purchase this whole kit. You can do this yourself. So that's it. Hope you enjoyed this part, and on to the next trigger. This next trigger are cotton balls. And I wanted to bring back these because they are one of my favorite ASMR triggers. I pretty much like them, almost just as much as Q-tips in the ears. And these Sparks mics, which I brought back for you after quite some time, because I wanted to experiment with those Rode mics. I tested them out for a good 3 months, just to see how the video sound would be, and your feedback. And surprisingly, not one person said that they wanted these old mics back. So I did think for a while that nobody noticed. But then I'm noticing significant changes in the audio, so I So I don't really like that here because there tends to be quite a lot of noise, which you never hear because I fix it in the editor, but there is almost constantly noise from my neighbors outside, and I just can't help it sometimes, but I do my best to keep it quiet on here. So these mics are way better for that, and they also have these cushions on them, which are good for rubbing things on. So I wanted to give that more broadband sound. So I will begin this trigger. It's jumbo size 400 count cotton balls, and begin. Noticed before I made this video, I was experimenting with the sound of both mics and how it would sound with a cotton ball. And when I rubbed these cotton balls on the Rode mic, the other mic, it made such a high metallic sound, like I was rubbing metal. And this one was so much smoother. It had more of a bass to it. Too cold to swim. The water candy. So now I'm going to be painting this rock pet, and this was also shown in the toy shop. Wow, I had a lot of these things shown in the toy shop that I didn't show completely. So here we go. And here's the paint. So, upon further inspection, you have the white paint. red, green, blue, and purple. So I'm going to leave this right about here and then show you the rock up close so I can paint it completely. Right about there. So I'm going to start off with his eyes and just go along. And see what I come up with. I thought this would make for a pretty relaxing video as well. Just close up attention to details, that kind of thing. And you can hear Poopsie chewing his food in the background. I decided not to move him so often because he's not that much of a bother. And he's really never, like, chirping loud during the day, usually, unless he wants something or wants me to take him out of his cage, which is fine. I do every day. But I'm more thinking in terms of videos. I find it actually pretty tingly if he's, like, crunching his beak or chewing his food. If you don't like it, you can let me know, but to me, he's my little sweet. For most videos, I do put them aside because I feel it wouldn't be fair to you if I just put my bird sounds in every video. That would be kind of a bit strange to do. There's no specific reason for me to be doing that. Okay. So, these colors are permanent. Just to let you know in advance if you ever wanted to get something like this. I'm just going along with some polka dots and painting. It's pretty cool to have a pet rock that's all blinged out, all colorful. Don't you agree? Not much sounds for this one, but nice to watch, I think. Okay. Just dotting them everywhere I can. Gotta make a little mouth here. Lips. Wipe off. So I don't blend the colors too much. It's fun to do these kind of activities just to let your mind wander. Bring you good luck. Okay. And he can have a little necktie thing going on here. Okay. more detail, the better. Finishing touch. He has to have some armor here and there to protect him in the forests, right? He's not a turtle without some armor. So there we go. Paint the back there. And do a good finishing touch. Make some different colors, like one here, one here, one here, one here, one here, one here. And that's basically the turtle. So, just a quick fun project to do with kids, even on your own if you're bored. Doesn't matter. Blend out all these colors, let's say, and make a really cool, messy, almost mosaic kind of stone. Different patterns here, just lightly tap with the brush to blend the colors together. Don't blend too much. Kind of just purposely make it look messy and unsolved. That kind of thing. Or you just basically ruin the whole rock. But you could do whatever you want with it because it's your rock. So that's it. Right. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed Poopsies. And I will see you very soon.